and gentlemen, we are here to address the issue of the 7 billion Ghana cedis arrears that is outstanding. So this brief will throw more light on the revelation made 2 days ago by the Vice President, His Excellency Alhaj Dr. Mahmoud Bawumia, on budget execution for 2016 and the uncovering of arrears which span the period 2014 to 2016. This brief is also in response to a press conference by the minority that clearly suggested that the NDC government ran a ministry that knew little about the extent of data transparency. If these issues are not addressed, it will threaten the ability of this government and future governments to deliver on their mandates. Ladies and gentlemen, in his revelation, the Vice President made known that an amount of over 7 billion as arrears has been uncovered in the process of interrogating data that was made available to the government. What is deeply worrying is the revelation, is that the arrears covered the period 2014 to 2016 and spanned the period during which negotiations of the extended current credit facility program with the IMF began. You will recall that the program with the IMF started in April of 2015, and we are uncovering arrears which spanned 2014 to 2016. On the face of the reality that the arrears dates back to 2014, then it would suggest that when the previous administration entered into negotiations with the IMF, full disclosure of data was not made available to the fund. Again, on account that arrears for 2015 and 2016 were also not fully disclosed, then it raises further questions on the integrity of data that we have been churning out over the past 8 years. Now, the implications for the deficit for 2016. Already, we are learning of a budget deficit on a cash basis of 8.5 to 9.5% of GDP. Now, the deficit projected for 2016 is hovering around 8.5 to 9.5% of GDP. This is data that has been supplied by the Bank of Ghana and the Ministry of Finance. These new uncovered arrears could put the overall budget deficit at 10 to 11% of GDP. Now, let's put this in perspective. For an economy like ours, with a size of $41.5 billion, the current deficit numbers show that in 2016 alone, our expenditures far outweighed our revenues by as much as $4 billion. Who financed these expenditures? Is it the Bank of Ghana through the banks, or is it from the $250 million that was provided to UBA Bank? Ladies and gentlemen, didn't President Mahama keep reminding us that his government was not going to overblow the deficit in the election year? How did this humongous deficit arise in spite of declarations to the contrary? What were staff at the Finance Ministry doing all this while? Now, the minority's reaction. In a response that could best be described as pathetic, the minority in Parliament sought to explain that the 7 billion of expenditures uncovered was due to reforms being undertaken on government contracts and expenditures, which is part of the gift mix project. So clearly, there's admission by the minority that the 7 billion cedis expenditure, which had been kept out of the purview of the books of government, constitutes rare expenditures that have been undertaken. So the deficit of 9.5% that we are talking about comes from data supplied by the Bank of Ghana and the Ministry of Finance. If you add on the 7 billion uncovered, then we reach the 11.5 that we are talking about as deficit for the year. The reaction by the former Deputy Minister, Atu Forson, which is sad and deeply worrying, depicts a team that is grossly unaware of the extent to which the nation's books may have been cooked to provide a false sense of good economic management and to deceive investors. More worrying is the fact that the former Deputy Minister attributed the arrears accumulation to reforms underway and the way in which data is captured. What the former Deputy Minister describes as creative accounting management is unethical and dangerous. the role of the IMF. We are of the view that given that the implementation of the External Credit Facility Program is still underway, the IMF stands in a better position to make some of these issues clear. As to whether this represents a breach of the ECF program conditionalities, we will know by the end of next week when the mission chief is expected to brief donors on his findings. We may recall that under the program, the government is not allowed to accumulate arrears. This may yet represent another serious breach of the program, and if care is not taken, punitive actions could be meted out against Ghana. Let us not forget that a similar occurrence in 2000 led to Ghana being fined $39 million by the IMF. In conclusion, ladies and gentlemen, we are aware of data integrity issues in certain institutions in this country. This new administration has promised to come clean on data, and we strongly believe that it is about time we cleaned up all the data mess. The change that has been fostered by the good people of Ghana presents a very good opportunity for institutions to come clean on data. So we appeal to all to come clean before the 2017 budget is finalized and read.